So what's the difference between SLIs, SLOs, and SLAs? SLA basically means an agreement. It's a formal agreement between you and your customer, and it basically describes the reliability of your product or service. So you can have a formal agreement which basically says, our product will be online 99% of the time annually, and if we fail to achieve that objective, we will give 30% of your annual license fee back. So SLAs also include penalties in the contract. So if you fail to meet certain level of reliability, you basically do something for your customer. Before we go on to SLOs, SLA is like a contract, which includes a lot of components, like, you know, in the contract. So it might include reliability of an API, reliability of the homepage, reliability of the dashboard, and so on and so forth. And each of these criteria are basically objectives that you want to achieve. So in the SLA, in the huge contract, you would have a section, which is SLO, and you would basically say, oh, my API will be up 99.99% of the time, and the error rate of the API will be less than 0.01% in a year, and so on and so forth. So SLO is basically, SLO basically describes the objective of a particular resource in your organization or in your product. SLI stands for Service Level Indicator, and what that means is, what's the current status of my API? So this is what monitoring tools tells you, like, you know, at this time. So if you open any monitoring tool out there that, like, that is actively monitoring your service, monitoring tool would tell you your API is currently up like 95% of the time, like this time of the year. And that's the SLI. So it's the current indicator. It's what exactly is my API doing right now. Like, thank you so much for watching. I hope this helps.